गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट अनदर बैक्टीरिया विच इज एसिड फास्ट बैक्टीरिया एंड इट डजंट कॉज ट्यूबरक्लोसिस। देयरफॉर द इनिशियली इट हैज बीन नेम्ड एज एटिपिकल बिकॉज द फीचर्स वर नॉट रिजेंबलिंग दैट ऑफ माइकोबैक्टीरियम ट्यूबरक्लोसिस विच इज कॉजिंग द ट्यूबरक्लोसिस डिजीज। देन अनदर नेम केम फॉर दैट, इट वॉज कॉल्ड एज एटिपिकल माइकोबैक्टीरिया एंड अनदर नेम केम दैट वॉज माइकोबैक्टीरिया अदर देन ट्यूबरकल बेसिलाई, दैट इज द मॉट। एंड नाउ द लेटेस्ट इट इज बीइंग कॉल्ड एज द नॉन ट्यूबरकुलस माइकोबैक्टीरिया। नाउ व्हाट इज दिस नॉन ट्यूबरकुलस माइकोबैक्टीरिया? दैट इज दे आर द डाइवर्स ग्रुप ऑफ माइकोबैक्टीरिया एंड दे आर आइसोलेटेड आइदर फ्रॉम बर्ड्स, एनिमल्स और फ्रॉम द एनवायरमेंट सर्फेसिस। दे कैन कॉज infection when there is some compromise from the immunity side. So there are the opportunistic pathogens, as only in a limited time they are related with the human infection. Man-to-man transmission is not there. There's another group of mycobacteria that is known as the saprophytic mycobacteria. So they are isolated from the soil or from some environmental surface, but they are not causing the disease in the humans. So that is the difference from these non-tuberculous mycobacteria. They can cause disease. Then it's classified. It was Runyon's classification was given for classifying these non-tuberculous mycobacteria. And what was that classification? Four were there. According to the production of pigment, they have a property to produce pigment, and also the rate of growth. So photochromosomes, photochromosomes, non-photochromosomes, rapid growers. So now one by one, what are photochromosomes? So these are the non-tuberculous mycobacteria which produce pigment only when exposed to light. So certain examples are under these photochromosomes, like Mycobacterium marinum. They are acquired from the water sources, and they usually enter through the traumas, and they will lead to the formation of ulcers. So that is known as swimming pool granuloma. Then there is important Mycobacterium kansasi, which can cause the chronic pulmonary disease, and it can be similar to the presentation could be similar to tuberculosis. So now comes as scotochromosomes. So they produce pigment even in dark and in light. So Mycobacterium scrofulaceum, that can cause the cervical lymphadenitis in children. Then there is another Mycobacterium gordoni that can commensals in tap water, and a common contaminant of the clinical specimens. Then comes the non-photochromosomes. So they do not produce any pigment either in dark or in light. Very important mycobacterium, that is the Mycobacterium avium intercellulare complex, comes under this. Now this complex has two important organisms, that is one is Mycobacterium avium, another is Mycobacterium intracellulare. So these why it is important? Because they are as one of the opportunistic pathogen in HIV infection. So when the CD4 T cell count comes under the 50, so at that time there can be a risk of this infection, and usually presents with the lymphadenitis, respiratory infection and disseminated disease. Then Mycobacterium xenopae, that can cause hospital water supply, may it can have present, can cause nosocomial outbreaks. Then Mycobacterium ulcerans can cause the buruli ulcer or painless ulcers. Then rapid growers. So usually the Mycobacterium tuberculosis takes 6 to 8 weeks to grow, but these Mycobacterium, they are rapid to grow. So almost they can grow within a week. Mycobacterium fauciem and chelonae, that can be important rapid growers. They cause post-trauma इंजेक्शन एब्सेस और कैथेटर रिलेटेड इन्फेक्शंस. देन माइकोबैक्टीरियम एब्सेस देन कैन कॉज द परमानेंट इन्फेक्शंस. नाउ हाउ वी कैन डायग्नोज, सो व्हाट कैन बी द स्पेसिमेंस. डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द सैंपल, इफ इट इज अ रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट इन्फेक्शन वी कैन हैव स्पूटम सैंपल. If there is lymphadenitis, we can take lymph node aspirate. Then there can be pus, exudates, biopsy. So depending upon where it is causing, what are the symptoms, so according to that, we can have different specimens. Now, it has a similar procedure as we do for tuberculosis bacteria. That is the important is the microscopy, Zidane staining. Culture, we can do it on algae media, Loenstein-Jensen media. And we can look for the pigment production. So usually we put two set of these algae media, one in dark and one in night. So one in dark and one in light. So we can see whether the pigment production is only in light or is in dark. So if both are there, according to that, we can say what type of non-tuberculous mycobacterial infection has been grown. Now, other methods like identification, when we want to differentiate from Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex, so we have different methods. That is, one is the MPT64 antigen by immunochromatographic test. So this antigen, MPT64, that is suggestive of tuberculosis infection. So there are immunochromatographic tests available, we can do for that. Biochemical tests are also there, like nitrate test, niacin test, so aryl sulfatase test. So different tests are biochemical there, which we help in differentiating these two groups. But now the newer methods are being preferred, that is the MALDI-TOF, that is the matrix-assisted laser desorption ionization time of flight, and the molecular methods, where we can know the species. We can differentiate it from Mycobacterium tuberculosis. It will be easy, difficult with the conventional method to differentiate. Now, how we can treat? So here also we need the multi-drug therapy also, because there is an emergence of drug resistance. So this usually like Mycobacterium avium intracellular complex, cancer C, so they all require multi-drug therapy. So with macrolide, clarithromycin or azithromycin, ethambutol and rifamycin. So NTMs, they are resistant to most of the antitubercul drug. So that's all. Thank you for paying attention.